Good morning and God bless you. We're delighted to have you with us here this morning. Maybe this is your first time joining us and tuning in. We want to extend a warm welcome to you and trust that you're blessed with what you hear today. We want to begin with prayer. We want to continue to pray for the direction and the condition of this nation. We want to continue to pray for our local region and community. We want to remember Cornerstone Pentecostal Church, and lastly, our brothers and sisters around the world. Maybe you have a special unspoken request. It's a perfect time to make that known unto God. Let's pray together. Father, we love you. We praise you. We worship you. God, we pray for the absolute abject lostness of our nation and our world. We pray for the influence of the Spirit of God, the Word of God, and the people of God upon the direction of this country. We also pray for our local community and region and pray that you'll open up doors of utterance. We pray for Cornerstone Pentecostal Church. And lastly, we pray for our brothers and sisters around the world that you would furnish them with a hedge of protection. We ask all these things in the name above every name, the name of Jesus Christ. Everybody said amen. One verse of scripture found here in the book of 2 Samuel, chapter number 12, and verse number 20. 2 Samuel 12, verse number 20. Then David arose from the earth and washed and anointed himself and changed his apparel and came into the house of the Lord and worshiped. Then he came to his own house, and when he required, they set bread before him, and he did eat. Verse number 20. Then David arose from the earth and washed and anointed himself and changed his apparel and came into the house of the Lord and worshiped. Amazing verse of scripture. Worshiping through the woundedness. Worshiping through the woundedness. Incredible passage of scripture. This is in the midst and on the heels of an incredible chapter in the life of David. Before this particular verse of scripture, David, of course, commits adultery with Bathsheba, has her husband ruthlessly killed in battle, takes this woman as his own wife, and the thing displeased the Lord. Part of Nathan's prophecy to David was that this child would not live. So David, of course, immediately repents and he goes into the house of God. He lays on the earth doing everything he can to circumvent the judgment of God that's already gone forth and been proclaimed upon this child, and the child dies. The child dies. The firstborn of David and Bathsheba. David goes in, washes himself, cleans himself up, anoints himself, changes his apparel, goes into the house of God and worships. He's already committed adultery. He's already killed an innocent man, one of the mighty men of David. His baby has died. And he is now in the house of God worshiping. I find this, I am not in approval in any way, shape, or form of David's great sin. Two capital offenses against the Decalogue, which is adultery and the murder of this good, innocent man. I'm not in any way, shape, or form in David's corner on this, but David is a wounded man. David is a hurting man. It's said by biblical historians that David played the hypocrite for almost a year, And David and God sends Nathan the prophet to David to confront David. You know the story. David gives a supernaturally given story to David that reveals to David. He finds himself in the story. And the prophet says, "Thou art the man." And so David is guilty of adultery. David is guilty of murder. This innocent baby now dies. And David changes his clothes, anoints himself, and goes into the house of God and worships. He is worshiping God in the midst of his woundedness. I've seen people over the last 28 years that although they're wounded through some self-inflicted wound, maybe it is adultery, maybe it is immorality, maybe it is some hideous sin, and it completely shuts them down. Here we see David worshiping God in the midst of his woundedness, praising in the midst of his problem, worshiping in his woundedness. I believe it is a healthy illustration. Once again, we're not in any way, shape, or form approving of what David has done. But David understands God is not to be blamed. This is something that I did. And David goes in the house of God and worships in his utter abject woundedness. One of the main points of rehabilitation, physical therapy, is that you have to keep moving at some point. I remember years ago, I was in a place that was an inpatient rehab clinic for people. There were many people that were in there. I was in there actually visiting another person. And this person was saying, "Oh no, I can hear this nurse coming and I know that they're gonna make me get out of bed. I don't wanna do this. They're gonna make me walk. They're gonna make me keep moving." The physical therapist came in and said, "It's time for you to take your laps." They had to walk around the building, walk around the floor. Regardless of whether they had IV attached, these units were on wheels. Regardless of what it was, there were many people already walking on the floor. What were they doing? Even though they were wounded, even though they were hurting, even though they didn't want to do it, there was a physical therapist that knew that if you're going to be healed, if you're going to move towards wholeness, you have to keep moving in your woundedness, in your pain. You have to pray through your pain. You have to worship in the midst of your woundedness. You have to continue to live for God in the midst of tragedy, fallout, and devastation. It is the will of the enemy that we shut down. We absolutely become utterly depressed. We cave in on ourselves, and it's all over. He wants us to be completely left in a mass of rubble. But notice David. Notice David, having learned that the baby is dead, gets up, changes his clothes, anoints himself, and goes into the house of the Lord and worships. I find that amazing. That David, although a wounded man, a shattered man, a man that is guilty of sin, a man that has sinned openly before the Lord according to the Ten Commandments, and yet he is worshiping in the house of the Lord. Maybe I'm talking to somebody here this morning that's thinking, "You know what, Pastor? I've just got this going on. I've got this going on." As long as you look at the problems, as long as you are responding to your woundedness, your feelings of hurt, your feelings of dejection, offendedness, whatever the case may be, don't allow that to stop you from worshiping through your woundedness, praying through the pain, continuing to be dedicated in the midst of devastation. And David went on. David went on as king, and David went on carrying out the prophecies, because we know that when Gabriel arrived many, many, many years in the future, when Gabriel arrived to that young Mary that was 14 years old, he said, "The baby that will be born of you will sit on the throne of David." Worshiping in the midst of woundedness. God bless you. Thank you for joining us here today. We'll look forward to seeing you tomorrow.